One of the problems with colon cancer is that it can be totally asymptomatic, which is why we screen. Screening allows us to catch things that are at an undetectable level to patients and even some clinicians. But patients with blood coming from the bottom, rectal bleeding, it can sometimes be fissures or hemorrhoids, but we always want to make sure we do our due diligence with that. Anemia, if someone's told you you're anemic for no apparent reason, change in bowel habits, and very rarely, but sometimes abdominal pain are some of the symptoms of colon cancer. Colon cancer has risen in the younger population, which is one of the reasons the United States Preventive Task Force has reduced the screening age from 50 years old to 45 years old. There is a significant amount of youth that are dealing with colon cancer and don't recognize that they're being affected by it. With colon cancer being such a horrible disease, a lot of my patients just want to sit on the idea of screening for it, right? Don't sit on colon cancer. Colonoscopy being the gold standard, it's very important that we get direct visualization, we sample any polyps that are there, but there are ways to continue screening even if you're not ready to make that step. And it's important to have that conversation with your primary care physician so that you can go through that shared decision-making process of what's best for you, because not screening is not an option. So we have Cologuard, which is a multi-targeted DNA study that can test your stool, recommended every 3 years or so. There are also some immunochemical tests, some stool blood samples, things that you can do yearly to give us some sense of what's going on. If you have any reservations about it at all, ask the questions that are preventing you from these life-saving screenings. And don't be afraid to take the next step of choosing a screening option that's best for you, because it could save your life and it could pay off down the line if your offspring or the next generation is aware that there's a family history of this and they can get screened earlier. So I would always encourage my patients to find a primary care physician, establish that relationship, and don't sit on colon cancer.